Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we continue with the topic computer vision, with specifically with OCR, object character recognition, and we are going to do today a small example with TCR in C Sharp. For those that are following the channel, you probably remember, I had done several videos of this topic using the different services that we had available in the cloud providers like Amazon or Google or Azure, or even with other providers, not included, specialized providers in OCR like OCR Space. And also, I make a comparison in between TCR and Paddle, a technology developed in China, which is also, well, very good in terms of OCR in this specific technique of extracting text from images of different types. So. TCR is a library, well known, very old library already. First it was released in 1985 by Hewlett Packard. Then on took over in the 90s, 96, if I don't remember, from Google, and he make it practically an standard. It improved it a lot, the library, introduced it as well, rewriting the library from C to C++, and also introducing later on models, language models, in kind of the recurrent neural networks, which the ability to in addition to the object character recognition, to the boundary recognition of characters in conjunction with the recurrent neural networks, are able to efficiently extract text from multiple languages. Today we will see an example using C Sharp. That is the what is different from the stuff you probably saw before. You are interested in this topic, you will see that, well, we improve in terms of the speed, not more, because what we did in Python is good, is exactly using the same model, so the technology is essentially the same. In terms of quality, the models, well, they are obviously refined from time to time. We already are in the version 5.4. It's no wrong. We can take a look later. I will patch you as well all the documentation. So the models, they had multiple models, but you can see here they are not touched for the past practically 6 years. So they are pretty stable. As I said, this technology, some of them 4 years, I don't know even which languages they are. So we had a lot of models here, different languages. Last release of the models was in 2021. This is the models. As I said, the models are quite stable, very efficient for the language. There is 172 different languages, if I'm not wrong. Let me check on the repository, because you want to replicate this, you will have to clone this repository. There is 137 items on the folder. We can exclude these 432, 133 different models. We have here a config. Although there are different language variants, for example, Chinese, there is 4 languages. Arabic 2 or 3, so there is multiple variants, because, well, I'm not as how to say, some of the languages I had no idea. I just took some examples and tested. We will cover in this tutorial, in this video, 4 different languages: Chinese, Arabic, Russian, and English. I couldn't find a good example of Hindu. Because, well, I test with a couple of files I found, but not really sure why it got, or if I was choosing the right model to extract from Hindu. Sorry for that. Probably somebody had can give me some good example of what is known as Hindu, because I know that there is different dialects or different languages, and it's very difficult. Well, for me, at least for me, I had no idea of this language, and then I decided finally not to include it in the video. But if somebody had a particular interest in some text, I can try with different models and get the best one for that specific language. In any case, we are going to see, as I said before, we will cover the installation, the libraries we need, and we will describe the small application that I prepared in it's a console application in C#. And then on again, we will see the output of four, five different examples. I had a part of the different languages, a couple of corner cases with tables, which is one of the most difficult scenarios for OCR technologies to extract, because OCR is using contours to detect the text, and we will look at some of the typical problems that we usually have when we are working with this technology. So again, I will patch you all these links where we have the libraries in C#, the data, the models that you need to download to local this. You have here also the documentation and the wrappers that you need for C#. I also, as I said, prepared some small program with the documentation. Here you have the original repository. Let me check if we have it here exactly. And you can see here, even read a brief of the history. As I said, this repo is still updated. They are maintaining the software. I don't think that in a daily basis, but you can see here that the last 2 weeks was touched. So this is it's a live repository. They still maintain it by the Google team under a patch license. And well, you can take a look. As I said, originally was developed in C. They were smooth ported to C++. The software, the most efficient library, obviously, is in C++, but you had versions or interfaces in Rust, in Python, in regulated the libraries in C++, in C#, like the one that we are going to use today, in Java. So you had APIs translations of the original, or bridges, because you can also find bridges in different languages to the DLLs in C++. Is for example, that's the one I'm using on my production models, a bridge in Python to the libraries in C++. So you had multiple options to use this software, and if you had interest, is a good solution, freeware that you can use in practically. It's gonna work very good accuracy in the majority of the files that you will have on your data lake. Obviously, there is the typical problems for OCR when you have. Obviously, the big problem is that you don't know what you are scanning, and then in the case that you are using this technology, you need you can set up the model in different modes. For example, when you have, this is a common problem in OCR, when you have two different paragraphs, two different columns with independent. This is very common in translation documents, official translations, where you had a language in the left and the translation in the right. Also from research papers, where you had the typical research paper which had two columns. This is one of the common problems in OCR, and it's not because it's not extracting correctly, but if you don't configure correctly the engine, by default the engine is going to read from left to right and from top and top down, and then you need to set up or to tell the machine or to at least in teaser art to set up some specific modes to detect, for example here set up automate page segmentation to kind of detect different blocks in the image, and this way it can treat these blocks individually. You can say here the mod PSN3, is creating kind of areas where from where to extract the data. So it's doing very well, as you can see here, but you have to do this manually. And when you try to automatize this, for example, in a scan, and you want to extract text from a multiple files in a data lake, you don't know beforehand what you are gonna find there, no? So this is a common problem that you may find when you try to work with these technologies. Others are, for example, one of the things that we will see today on the video is this kind of tables, which you had text, but in some of the cases are very close to the boundaries of the or to the box or to the edges of the box, and this is very hard for the technology to detect the, you can see the image natural size, or and then on for the model is quite hard, very hard, not to create the contours of every single character, and later on match them with the neural network with the language model. But yeah, in any case, as I said, they are corner cases. Most of the documents that you may scan are less complicated. We will see, for example, a form. In the example, this is working really well, and some other languages. We will see Arabic, Chinese, traditional English, Russian, and a couple of tables to show you what are the conventional problems. No, this is one example that you may face. It's pretty nice, the picture, but this is a killing for the OCR. Okay, I will explain you later when we do the follow the examples. As I said, I have prepared a small application. Here you have the links. You need to install these two packages, Spectra and Tesseract OCR. This Spectre is just an application to build console applications nicely, nice applications of console, and also the Visual Studio runtime, 32 or 64 bits, depending on the machine that you want to install, that contains Tesseract, TLR, and Lectonica. So if you pretend to redistribute an application, you will have to add that. So the models, you need to do a clone of this repository and then on making them available to the application. The application is pretty simple. We use this Spectre in previous videos as well, so we will not cover too much. So it's a class, a main class, console helper. We have a header. We have a method to get the folder where we have the models, language models. This is to get the path of the image, to get the language to use on the model, and to get the path where you will save the text file, the extracted text file, and here just to write arbitrary messages to the console. Constants to be used during the interaction with the application. It's essentially constants that we will inject into the flow. The flow is pretty simple. We start the console application. We get the path for the models. We enter in a loop. We ask for the path of the image. We ask for the language of the model to use. We create an engine. We use the default mode. As I said, there is different modes. I will patch you the link to the documentation. As I said, you don't know beforehand what you had. If you know beforehand, you can set up. We can create another parameter to set up this mode to extract the text from, for example, as I explained you before, to create these areas to detect these areas or blocks in the image, but in this case we are going to use essentially the default mode, and there is, I don't remember, 6 different modes. If you know what you had in the image beforehand, you can decide to use a different mode for that specific image. It's not the default, and it's something is not working according, is not working good, or the score that you get from that image is very low. You can try with different modes. The same with language. We don't know what we have in a data lake in images, so by default I used to work with English, and then only some of the images are very very low score. I try with other languages. Here the library comes with some tools to open images, like Pillow in Python. Here is just simply we open the PIX. It's opening an image in pixel format, and with the image we pass the image to the engine, and then you get a confidence. This is telling you how confident or how good is the extraction that you got with that specific language and with the mode that you choose to extract the text from the image. And then here we just press a key to continue, and we ask for a path to write the text in the file disk, in the file system, and we essentially write it down in with this the typical file string to Dix. It's pretty similar to what we do in Python. We close everything in a try catch blocks, and finally here just simply continue the loop. Just press a key to continue, or press a escape to leave the application. So I have here the application. Let's run it again. And then we are going to start with the image. So first of all, it's asking for the path of the models. So I will show you again this, just to every model, as you can see here, had a prefix, that train data. This prefix is the language. I will pass you later on as well on the documentation of the video what means all these languages: Bulgarian, Catalan, Italian, Chinese. You see there is different versions of Chinese, and we are gonna do one with Chinese traditional. Yeah, so you have to use this prefix ENG or CHI underscore TRA, TRA, for choosing Chinese traditional. So enter the image. Now we are going to get to use the this one, which is the English one. We use the ENG engine, and now you get the score, and finally a score of 0.9, and here just press a key to continue. We put the path eng.txt. Now let's check what we have. Eng. You can take a look here to the, let me put it down here. Yeah, you have here that and the image somewhere here. So you can take a look, it's quite, come on. Okay, so yeah, it's very good. The translation, well, English is clear that it's gonna be, here just this logo is not correctly, but the rest is pretty much perfect. Let's try now with another language, Chinese, for example. Press aquí, I'm going to open the Chinese image. Chinese traditional. And now we are getting a 0.91. Press aquí. Oops. No, here. And the path to the image. So here, Chinese. TST. We open it. So we have here and the image somewhere here. So you can check. It's pretty much identical. You can check one by one. I had no idea of Chinese. I would like, but unfortunately, no idea. So if somebody understands this and it can confirm that the characters are correctly translated, I will appreciate it. So please write something on the comments and let us know that it is correctly done. Let's try now Russian. Or Arabic, I don't know what is now, Russian. Let's take the Russian image, Rush, and let's put the image in Russian is not very good quality, but in any case, it's making very good job. You have here the, and you have here the image, so Samolstu Prosta Niet. Here you can see here. This is Nie. This is a little bit the image is a little bit bad quality. Svatilo Solit Topliva Chobi. So it's quite good. Ikruska. Let's, tab on Dotsnin. Russian is quite good. I can tell you that is really, really good done. And now let's try with Arabic. Probably also I have no idea of Arabic, unfortunately, as well. So if somebody understand Arabic, please let us know. Ara, here is the language. If this is also correct, because the same happens with the Hindu. I couldn't find even a good text. Arabian TXT, and we had the image here, which I think is really good extracted as well. But anyway, if somebody who is following the channel understand the language, can let us know if this is correct or not correct. I will pass all these images as well later. You can see here we had two languages. We can specify as well two languages to the engine when it's just simply here. is when you say engine language, here we just use one. If you put plus another language, another prefix, you can use multiple. Just you need to concatenate them with using the symbol plus, and then the Tesseract will be able to translate in different using different languages. So now we are going to use a table where I had the table that one, the big one. Now, for example, stable PNG. The small one. This is ENG English, and then on the image is not very good quality. You will understand now why. I will explain you why this is not working very well. And this is essentially how the technology works. So we have the table. As you can see here, the table have, let me show you as well, the code here. We have the table. So as you can see here, where is failing is in these headers. Why? Well, usually when you do OCR, what you are doing is transforming first of all the image to black and white, and then on you create the contours, the edges of the characters. Here, what's going to happen when we do this, as the background is how to say, more close to black than the letters, here is going to find a lot of difficulties finding or creating the contours of this text with this with a background with this, the letters are in white and the background is not is the opposite color. Now, the worst case scenario is when you had the background in black and the letters in white, and together you had like happen in this example. So you have so the model follows a unique approach, no? And this is I detect the letters when there is a change on the distribution of the color, when you are getting close to the contour of the letter C, there is a change on the distribution of the color. And then here is more evidence when there is colors that are very far than here. And then on once you see the you get an approach, it's very difficult later kind of detect it when you had practically how to say all the rest of the text or the rest of the image that had practically a similar approach. Now when you change when the image is having this kind of combinations that there is differences in between what is the color used for letters and the background, and then we use here on the header the opposite. This is making very complicated to the model to detect where are the contours of those letters. That's why the first header is having a lot of difficulties. You can see that the rest is practically perfect. There is no problem. And there is, again, this is one of the scenarios where OCR is not working completely well, if you want to say that. Now we are going to see the second corner case when you had a table where you had a lot of bounding boxes, and then on also when you have, for example, cases like here, very close characters to the boundaries of the box, is also very hard for the model to create the contours of these characters. We will see the example now. and you will see how in these places where there is kind of overpopulation of characters, that is very difficult for the model to create the contours and later on to match with the language model to the right letter. OCR is ENG, and here we will write. Now it's gonna take a while because there is here a lot of text to extract. Well, not a lot, but yeah, it's more than the rest. It's pretty confident in any case. You remember in the other was practically 0.60. Here is 0.82, is good confidence, and you will see now that there is also some mistakes. In general, the language is okay, the structure is okay, but you can see here, yeah, it's having some issues. Let's check here. You can see here PII, information type PII, but for example, these pipes shouldn't be there, and this is, as I said, is quite hard many times to identify the, or the basically the model is mislead. Now, for example, here is identify high security identifier. Where is this? You can see here. This here is having issues. Here as well. Here as well. So when these characters are very close all together with this line, for the model it's very difficult to create the contours of the letters, and later on, well, it's essentially believing that we have here another character which in fact it doesn't exist. But in any case, it's still good enough for most of the cases. As I said, these are corner cases that regardless the technology that you are using, you are gonna have problems. It doesn't matter if you use the commercial services in Amazon, in Azure or Google or others. You can see the videos on the channel. We try all of them, and all of them had similar problems when you go to the corner cases. Some others are some cases more efficient, detecting, for example, when you had to work in blocks. This is, yeah, some of models are, well, the logic itself is pretty much the logic behind, or the application is more flexible, but all these corner cases is well, all of them are suffering, all the applications are suffering a lot with these corner cases. In any case, it's a technology still to consider. It's free. You can set up very nice applications with very good accuracy and most of the files. If you have the opportunity, I don't know, you can scan or visualize the image before scan. You need to automatize some cases. You are not gonna be very successful. But if you have the chance to just visualize the image and choose which mode or which language you want to use, it's really, really very efficient and very fast to build an application with Tisserar and Cesar or C++, and it's working, in my opinion, really well. You can also get the commercial versions because all of them are under the hood using that. And well, we'll see in the future. In my opinion, this is going to be overpassed by the LLMs, multimodal LLMs. We saw also some examples on the channel, and they are using a completely different approach. They are simply read the unstructured data, and then on is practically impossible to beat that. They don't have the problems of the how the information is organized. And if you had a model with enough context windows and LLM, it's gonna be always beating the OCR techniques, regardless the good that they are. It's gonna be always better an LLM, because obviously even you can establish a conversation with your document. But in any case, this is another topic. You had as well some examples of the channel, and if you had interest, you can ask me. I can point you out to some of the other videos. The same for all the series in OCR. And that's pretty much all. I hope that it was useful or interesting for you, for your job, for whatever reason, for your training, for your studies, or just for interest, for whatever reason that you are watching these videos in the channel. And if so, give me a like, subscribe to the channel, share, make comments and all this stuff to help me to grow in YouTube. Thank you very much and see you soon.